The president has set a May 12th deadline to decide if he will end U.S. involvement in this deal. This morning we have Behnam Ben Tablu from the Foundation for the Defense of Democracies. Behnam, we appreciate you coming in. All right, so earlier this week, before the president spoke one day, Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu comes out and he gives this almost lecture-like presentation about all the things Iran has been doing to violate this deal. Have they been breaking this the entire time?
We know that Iran has been violating the spirit of the text of the deal, as well as the letter of the UN Security Council resolution.
How are they doing this?
In terms of the spirit of the deal, they've actually played around with some of their centrifuges a little bit more, done some more R&D that they shouldn't have done, but most importantly that they've violated the arms transfer and ballistic missile testing prohibitions of the UN Security Council resolution, which codifies the Iran nuclear deal. What the Netanyahu documents show is Iran's past nuclear weapons work, mostly which we knew existed, but we did not know to this amount of detail and to what amount of interest Iran had in uranium and metallurgy, for instance.
The 1-2 punch between Netanyahu and then the president immediately following him that day in his own news conference was eye-opening to a lot of folks. But, you know, the president raises this point. Why should the United States honor an agreement that one of the parties to it, Iran, doesn't seem to be honoring itself?
Well, Iran has an interest, in fact, in retaining the deal because it's so heavily slanted in its favor. I think the way the president set up the discussion about the Iran deal was actually quite good. It's that the deal gives Iran more than it gives the United States, and the president is in a good position to try to renegotiate that deal, and I hope he weaponizes the Netanyahu documents in his debate with Europe to actually fix the deal before May 12.
Iran has been a pariah on the world stage for close to 40 years right now, and this deal was supposed to be their step back in to the brotherhood of nations. When they don't honor something like this, what does it say to the wider world about how an agreement with Iran will be taken?
I think first and foremost, it shows that you can't have a limited deal with this type of regime. This type of regime, as you mentioned, for 40 years, it's only been in power for 40 years. It came through entered it in the world stage through an act of international terrorism. It took U.S. Diplomats hostage in 1979, as you remember. But the deal is supposed to pave the way for Iran to reconnect with the world banking system. How can you reconnect this country with the world banking system when it's ascendant in Syria, when its terrorist capabilities have grown, and when the nuclear deal does not address the regional aspects of Iran's bad behavior?
In a wider world, a lot of people have been tying together what's been going on in North Korea with the president's pressure program on North Korea, which seems to have produced results. And looking at Iran, would the same course of action that has been used against North Korea work successfully in Iran? Maximum pressure?
Absolutely. But as much as I support the president using maximum pressure, he should use that pressure to get a better and different nuclear deal.
What would be better?
What would be better is if you include the three things the U.S. is looking to include with Europe in the nuclear deal. That's ballistic missiles, which is the delivery vehicle for a nuclear weapon, military site inspections, which the IAEA can do but hasn't done yet, as well as sunset clauses, removing the limitations that will expire, removing the expirations on the limitations on Iran's nuclear program. We want a permanent cap to this program.
We thank you so much for coming in this morning to talk about this. Obviously, May 12th is coming up. We'd like to have you back in again after
thank
we
you.
Decide what it is the United States is going to be doing when the president finally reveals that.
Thank you so
much. All right, we thank you so much.
Pleasure.
All right, coming up next.